Hello students,
I am your biology lecturer.
In the previous class we completed the chapter biotechnology and its principles. Today we will discuss about the important questions of the biotechnology chapter. First of all, I list out here 31 questions for the short answers, short questions, and 6 questions for 5 marks. Okay, I will explain the answers for 1 marks question. I will not explain 5 marks questions. Okay, first question for 1 mark or 2 marks, it will come for 1 mark or 2 marks. The definition of biotechnology, the question is here. See once again, what is biotechnology? In the introduction class only I explained about the biotechnology. Biotechnology is a branch of science which helps the synthesis of product from the living organism or their components. The product must be helpful for the industries and the mankind. Okay, then what is DNA ligase? The DNA ligase, the question is, what is DNA ligase? The DNA ligase is an enzyme which helps to join the two DNA ends or two DNA fragments. I think all of you remembered that one. The DNA is digest or cut by using the restriction enzyme. Those are called as RENs. Restriction enzymes na venanta heltivi RENs. Those RENs will make the DNA into different fragments. Okay, those fragments after lysation is joined with the help of DNA polymerase enzyme. DNA polymerase are the enzyme which helps to join the two DNA fragments after lysation. Okay, then next question is, what is electrophoresis? What is electrophoresis? Particularly if I ask like this, what is gel electrophoresis? Okay, first of all the question is, what is electrophoresis? Electrophoresis is a technique which is used to separate the DNA fragments. Okay, agarose gel electrophoresis is mainly useful for separation of DNA fragments. After lysation, the many DNA fragment will form. Those fragments are separated with the help of agarose gel electrophoresis. Okay, next, draw the diagram of gel electrophoresis. Adakke neevu ondu rectangular gel chamber na tagibeku. Then after that you have to mention the wells, then separation of DNA fragments, large fragment and the small fragment, electricity, anode and cathode. ಒಂದು ರೆಕ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ತೆಗೆದು ಅದರೊಳಗಡೆ ವೆಲ್ಸ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು. ವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟು ಫಾಸ್ಟಾಗಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ದೆನ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟು ಸ್ಲೋ ಆಗಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಥೋಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಆನೋಡ್, ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಎಂಡಿಂದ ಹಿಡಿದು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಎಂಡ್ವರೆಗೂ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಡಿ ಎನ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಅ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್. Okay, next question, what is restriction enzymes? Restriction enzymes are the enzymes which are used to break down the DNA. There are two kinds of restriction enzymes are there, endonucleases and the exonucleases. The next question is like that only, but if the question is like this, what is restriction enzyme, you have to answer like,
Distinction enzymes are the enzymes which are used to break down the DNA at the specific location, which are very necessary for the recombinant DNA technology. Okay, then our next question is, what is palindromic sequences? Palindromic sequences are present on the DNA, which we can read from both the directions, forward and the backward direction. If the sequence, if we read from 5 prime to 3 prime direction, the next 3 prime to 5 prime direction, both the strands of DNA have the same sequences, which are anti-parallel to each other. Those palindromic sequences are the recognition site for the endonucleases or the exonucleases. Totally distinction enzymes. Distinction enzyme will find the palindromic sequences to bind the DNA. Next question is, what are endonucleases enzymes and the exonucleases? First of all, understand the meaning of exo and endo. Endo in the sense inside. Okay, the question is like here, what are endonucleases enzyme? Endo means inside, nucleases means enzyme which used to break down the nucleus. Endonucleases are the enzymes which are used to break down the DNA in the middle. Okay. Then the next question is, what are exonucleases? Exonucleases in the sense, those are the enzymes which cuts the DNA ends, 5 prime or 3 prime ends. Next question is, what is function of gel electrophoresis? Just understand, students. I explained about the gel electrophoresis in two classes. Okay, the question is like this here. What is the function of gel electrophoresis? In the previous question only I explained about this one, but the answer is, gel electrophoresis, due to the gel electrophoresis, the separation of DNA takes place. The separation of DNA takes place with the help of gel electrophoresis. Okay, next, what is the function of DNA ligase? DNA ligase is an enzyme which used to join the two DNA fragments. Okay, it's very simple, students. Gel electrophoresis is an enzyme which used to break down the DNA fragments. Next question is, what is recombinant DNA technology? What is recombinant DNA technology? Recombinant DNA technology is a principle of biotechnology where two genetic material, two organism genetic materials are fused to form a new progeny or two new offsprings. Okay, I explained detailedly the recombinant DNA technology steps and the tools. Next question is, what is rDNA? rDNA is nothing but the recombinant DNA. Recombinant DNA is formed due to the insertion of gene of interest into the plasmid DNA. Okay, then next question is, after tDNA, next question is, what is TI plasmid? TI plasmid is a plasmid which is present in the bacterium strain, that is Agrobacterium tuberculosis, which
have the DNA, which is very necessary for the recombinant DNA technology in case of plants. Agrobacterium is a species helps for the genetic engineering. Okay, next question. Next question is, what is plasmid or what is vector? Plasmids are the extra chromosomal circular DNAs, which are also known as molecular vehicles, which are usually present in case of human beings, chloroplast and the mitochondria. In case of bacteria, are also having plasmids. Plasmids are the extra chromosomal circular DNAs. Those DNAs having the antibiotic resistant genes, which are very necessary for movement of DNA, or those are called as molecular vehicles. Next, what is tDNA? tDNA is the DNA which is present on the TI plasmid of Agrobacterium tuberculosis, which is able to cause the crown gall disease. Remember, tDNA which is present in the Agrobacterium plasmid. Next, what is Agrobacterium plasmid? Agrobacterium plasmid, which is present inside the Agrobacterium species, Agrobacterium tuberculosis, which is able to cause the disease, which is able to cause crown gall disease. Okay, next. Next question is, mention tools of recombinant DNA technology. Tools of recombinant DNA technology. Recombinant DNA technology, useful enzymes are DNA ligase, distinction enzymes, gel electrophoresis, then PCR. Everything comes under the tools of recombinant DNA technology. Next question. What are selectable markers? Selectable markers are MPCillin resistant gene and the tetracycline resistant genes, which are present in the plasmid, artificially synthesized plasmid, helpful for recognition of transformants and non-transformants. Transformants mathe non-transformants ge difference irli anta there is a presence of selectable markers. Next question is, what are bioreactors? Bioreactors are the large scale recombinant DNA technology devices, or the vessels, large or the big vessels, which helps for the recombinant DNA technology, which will help growth of recombinant DNA in a large scale, which provides the optimum condition for the culturing the bacteria or growth of bacteria. Next question is, what is gene gun technique or the biolistics? Those are the gene gun technique or the biolistics are the technique help for the isolation. Helps for the insertion of gene of interest into the host organism. Gene gun is a physical method for of insertion of gene of interest into the host organism. The next question is, what is micro injection? Micro injection is also one of the technique of insertion of gene of interest into the host. Okay, micro injection is a small injection, micro pipette or injection. It is a micro pipette or the injection helps to insert gene of interest directly into the nucleus of the host organism. Nucleus olage gene of interest to nucleus na tagondu direct olage host organism insert madabodu. Okay, then what is competency? Competency in the sense making the bacterial cell permeable for the foreign DNA, making bacteria to allow the movement of DNA within innate. Okay, then next question is, what is tag polymerase? Tag polymerase is an enzyme which is used in the PCR technique or PCR technology, which have high temperature resistance. Tag polymerase enzyme, which is isolated by Thermus aquaticus bacterium. Thermus aquaticus bacterium, the tag polymerase in isolate martara. This tag polymerase helps in the multiplication or amplification of DNA fragments, which is inserted inside the PCR. PCR is nothing but the polymerase chain reaction. The next question is that one only. What is PCR? PCR is the polymerase chain reaction. Okay, this is the technique which is used to amplify or the multiply of gene of interest. It is a molecular coughing Xerox machine. Means if you inserted a small piece of DNA, it will form many DNA strands. Okay, then mention the steps which are involved in the PCR. Mention the steps. First step in the PCR, that is denaturation. In the denaturation step, there is the separation of double stranded DNA into the single stranded DNA. Here double stranded DNA na single stranded DNA convert mado step again heltivi denaturation. Okay, next question. Second step in the PCR, that is a primer extension. At the 3' prime end of each DNA strands is going to attach with the help of primer. Primer will provide the double stranded DNA for the tag polymerase, then only the extension of DNA will possible. Okay, third step in that PCR is extension.
First one denaturation, second one annealing, third one is extension. After primer annealing, primer have to extend. The DNA strands have to be formed with the help of single stranded DNA. It is known as a third step of PCR. Okay, I will just mention here. First step in PCR is denaturation. Second step is primer annealing. Third one is the extension of the DNA. Next question. What is recombinant protein? See here. By the recombinant DNA technology, the recombinant DNA will form. After that, we have to insert that recombinant DNA into the particular host. In that host of the organism, in host or the organism, the normal protein synthesis occurs. The recombinant DNA also undergoes protein synthesis to form the protein called as a recombinant protein. Recombinant DNA technology in the N gene na alter madirthivi, that gene undergoes to the protein synthesis, the formed protein is called as a recombinant protein. Okay, next, what is elution? Just after the gel electrophoresis separation, gene of interest have to be isolate, then that gene of interest is mixed with chilled ethanol or many solvents, washing of the DNA with the solvents in order to get the pure DNA is known as a elution, washing of DNA with the help of solvent. Next question. What is ethidium bromide? I hope all of you remember this one. Ethidium bromide is a stain. Just after explaining about the gel electrophoresis, I already mentioned the function of ethidium bromide in usual classes. Ethidium bromide is a stain which is used to stain the DNA. It is an intercalary agent which is mixed with the DNA. It forms the DNA has a bright orange color which is helpful for visualization of DNA just after gel electrophoresis. Gel electrophoresis admele, we have to add or stain the DNA with the help of ethidium bromide. What is ethidium bromide? Ethidium bromide is a stain which is used to stain the DNA. Intercalary agent anta karithivi navu. Next, what is bioreactor? What are bioreactors? Bioreactors are the large scale vessels which are useful for large scale production of genetically modified product which will provide the optimum condition for the growth of the bacteria. Finally, we can get a large scale product from the bioreactor. It is an automated machine. The optimum temperature, pH, food or culture will provide within the bioreactor. Next. What is downstream processing? Downstream processing is the final step of the recombinant DNA technology. The product have to be isolate, purify, and the purification, isolation, processing and marketing steps comes under the downstream processing. and the purification and quantification is done in the downstream process. Next question. What is ligation? Ligation is the process of fusion of gene of interest on the plasmid with the help of DNA ligase. This step is known as a ligation. Ligation. Okay. Next. 5 marks questions. 5 marks questions. First one. Explain recombinant DNA technology. You have to explain each and every step in the recombinant DNA technology. If possible, you have to draw the diagram also. Diagram haki explain madidra, you can get a full marks. Okay. Explain the recombinant DNA technology. You have to mention the steps like isolation of DNA, isolation of plasmid, gel electrophoresis, second one is digestion, gel electrophoresis and transformation, after transformation, last one is downstream processing. You have to explain detailedly with the diagram. Okay, then explain the PCR technique. Okay, in the PCR also you have to draw the diagram. Double stranded DNA after denaturation, single stranded DNA, primer aligning and the extension part you have to show in the diagram with the help of diagram, and you have to explain denaturation, extension and aligning steps. Okay, then next one is explain gel electrophoresis. You have to draw the diagram and you have to explain the principle of gel electrophoresis, function of gel electrophoresis with the diagram. Okay, in the principle you have to mention on the basis of what the separation of DNA takes place. Then next thing is, next question for the 5 marks is
explain the structure of PBR-322. This is very important one. You have to draw the diagram, then you have to label it neatly. Neat agi diagram draw maadi pratiyondu labeling na neat agi mention maadbeku, then explain maadbeku.
What are recognition sites, what are selectable markers, what is ORI site. Okay, pratiyondune explain maadi amele ampicillin tetracycline bhala sathi repeat aagtade. This is very important diagram. Then next question is mention the tools of recombinant DNA technology and their function. First tool, distinction enzyme and its function, DNA ligase and its function, gel electrophoresis and its function, host organism and its function, then PCR and its function. Okay, ellado tools anna mention maadi adar jothege adar function annu mention maadbeku. Okay, then next question is explain the process of genetic material isolation. Okay, genetic material isolation, like, okay, we have to break the cell wall. If it is the recipient cell is the plant cell idra, we have to use cellulase enzyme. Animal cell idra, there is no requirement of breaking down the cell wall. If it is bacterial cell, we have to use chitinase. Sorry, fungal cell idra chitinase, bacterial cell is the protease enzyme na use maadi we can break down the cell wall of the recipient cell, then only you can get the gene of interest. Okay, genetic material isolation ge we have to use the salt solutions also. heat shock treatment in the salt solution in the DNA isolation madbeku. After grinding madodrinda, means in case of plant, we have to grind the leaves of the plants or any other part. Then we have to centrifuge. After that, we have to use the chilled ethanol to get the pure DNA. Okay, this is a process of isolation of genetic material. Okay, this is all about the important questions of biotechnology. Please prepare answer for all these questions. We will continue in the next chapter. I will take a new chapter in the next class. Okay, I hope all of you will prepare the answer for these questions. Okay, bye. Thank you.